said, as he entered the world, "Behold, I come to do your will, O God." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning. Today the Church celebrates the beautiful solemnity of the Annunciation. We begin our celebration by standing humbly in God's presence, mindful of our need for His mercy, His forgiveness, so we might live in His peace. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring each of us to everlasting life. And on this beautiful solemnity of the Blessed Mother, we join all the angels and saints as we say, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who willed that your word should take on the reality of human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we, who confess our Redeemer to be God and man, may merit to become partakers even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the netherworld or high as the sky. But Ahaz answered, I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord. Then Isaiah said, Listen, O house of David. Is it not enough for you to weary people? Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. The word of the Lord. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. Sacrifice or oblation you wish not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Holocaust or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, Behold, I come. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. In the written scroll is prescribed for me. To do your will, O God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips as you, O Lord, know. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. Your justice I kept not hid within my heart. Your faithfulness and your salvation I have spoken of. I have made no secret of your kindness and your truth in the vast assembly. Hear my word, I come to do your will. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, it is impossible that the blood of bulls and goats take away sins. For this reason, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offerings you do not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocausts and sin offerings you took no delight. Then I said, as is written of me in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O God." First he says, sacrifices and offerings, holocausts and sin offerings, you neither desired nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law. Then he says, behold, I come to do your will. He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated to the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who is called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. Simply put, what a difference a word makes. And today we celebrate that word, that fiat, that yes, that Mary offered the angel. What a beautiful scene. I'm sure many of us at different times in our prayer have taken a moment to try to imagine that beautiful gift of imagination that God gives to us, to imagine that scene. I always imagine it as Mary, just in her room, quiet, maybe praying, and all of a sudden, there's this great silence, and this great presence, this divine presence, this holy presence, an angel. This angel speaks to her, and Mary's mixed with emotions of fear and confusion, a little trembling. At the very same time, she doesn't lose her calm. She doesn't lose her peacefulness. And she hears and receives the message of the angel. And while she asks the very practical question, how can this be? She understands she hasn't been with a man. And that's when the divine revelation is told to her that this child she will bear will be through the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit, the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit. And thus, the child to be born, we call the Son of God. She was being asked to be the mother of God. Just try to imagine what was going through her heart, her mind, her imagination. What could that possibly mean to be the mother of God? She had no idea. Dare say none of us would have any idea what that would have meant. But that didn't stop her from uttering that one life-changing, history-changing word, yes. And at one point you realize she's not quite sure what she's saying yes to. All she's saying is, yes, I trust my God. Be done to me according to your word, according to the will of God. And thank God she said yes. Then the history of salvation, history was able to unfold because of her yes. So we honor her and we thank her for her yes. But we're also reminded that we're called to imitate her. The first word we hear about her is yes. And that's something for us to think about. Is that the first word that we utter? Do we say yes to God? Or do we say, wait a second, God, before I say yes, let me know what's going on here. Explain yourself to me. Let me know how it's going to work out. But that's not how God works. But when we say yes to God, then we say yes to being led. Remember, we do call ourselves followers of Jesus. We don't lead, we follow. And we follow his divine plan as revealed and unfolded for us day by day, decision by decision, to choose to do God's will. We're about to say those beautiful words of the Our Father in a few moments. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And that's ultimately what Mary's yes was. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So today let's ask for the intercession of the Blessed Mother that we too will say yes. And realize that we have said yes along the way. We said yes to our baptism, our first Holy Communion. How many of you said yes that you stood the altar nervously holding your beloved hand and promising to be true to each other, faithful to each other, good times and bad times, rich, poor, sickness, health, until death do you part. How many men and women throughout history have laid on the floor of a sanctuary and said yes to God as they profess the evangelical counsels of poverty, chastity, and obedience and consecrated life? How many men have said yes as they placed their hands in the hands of their bishop and promised respect, obedience to him and all his successors? How many of us say yes when our pastor asks us to lead a ministry, to get involved in something in the parish, to step up our commitment to the Lord and his people and the mission of the church to go spread the good news? We're called so often to say yes. Let's realize today as we celebrate Mary's yes, it ought to be the strength and the example for us that we may say yes. And on the solemnity of the Annunciation, let us together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we seek to follow the example of Mary's faith, let us entrust our petitions to our Father in heaven. And so we pray. For the leaders of the Church, may the Lord richly bless them in their ministry and protect them from all evil that surrounds them, we pray. For our national leaders, may God grant them compassion and insight in acting for the common good, we pray. For the sick and all those who care for them, may God grant them healing, relief, and peace, we pray. For our local parish family of Our Lady of the Mount, may the Holy Spirit continue to empower us in saying yes to what God asks of us, we pray. For all those who died, may they be welcomed into the heavenly kingdom by Mary, Saint Joseph, and all the saints. We pray. And for the intentions of Joe and Lisa Clemente. We pray. Father, we entrust our prayers to you in the holy name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become the body of Christ, our bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become the blood of Christ, our spiritual drink. friends in my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your church's offering, so that she, who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son, may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Together let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that the Christ was to be born among men, and for men's sake, by the overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit, lovingly she bore him in her immaculate womb, that the promise to the children of Israel might come about, and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus the Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, gave you thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. When supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered together in one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of the Mountain, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and martyrs, Saints Francis and Clare, each of our patron saints and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Love God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. spiritual gain. Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to obtain eternal joy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And through the intercession of the Blessed Mother, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.